Okay, so you already know Google, but how familiar are you with its parent company, Alphabet? Well, beyond its ubiquitous search engine, have you ever wondered how this tech titan continues to grow and thrive in an increasingly competitive market? Well, in the words of CEO Sundar Pichai,
with 15 products that each serve a half a billion people and six that serve over 2 billion each, we have so many opportunities to deliver on our mission.
That's right, 15 products used by over half a billion people and many more. In today's deep dive, we'll review how Google makes money, business insights from YouTube to cloud, earnings call insights and the recent announcements around generative AI, and explore what the future holds, particularly with Google's new AI model, Gemini. Hi there, I'm Bertrand, and I'm the founder of App Economy Insights. Let's dive straight into Alphabet's financials for the third quarter of fiscal year 2023, where numbers tell a tale of growth and resiliency in a competitive digital economy. Alphabet reported a staggering $77 billion in revenue with an impressive 11% year-over-year growth. A closer look reveals the segments that are driving this surge. Advertising remains the powerhouse, bringing in nearly $60 billion and up 9% year-over-year. Within this, search revenue stood strong at $44 billion, growing 11% year-over-year. YouTube ads, a vital part of Alphabet's portfolio, clocked in at $8 billion, a commendable 12% year-over-year increase. And the other segment, which includes Google Play, hardware, and subscriptions, it saw a robust growth of 21%. YouTube subscription, particularly YouTube TV, and to a lesser extent, music and premium, drove the growth, though no exact numbers were provided. Meanwhile, cloud continues its upward trajectory with a 22% increase to $8.4 billion, though it was a slight deceleration from previous quarters. Management attributed this to customers optimizing workloads. It's a recurring challenge in recent quarters for hyperscalers. In terms of profitability, Alphabet's gross margin stood at 57%, while operating margin reached 28%. These figures not only reflect the company's efficient cost management, but also its ability to sustain profitability in the context of a challenging microenvironment. Alphabet's cash flow paints a healthy financial picture too. Operating cash flow hit $31 billion, while free cash flow was $23 billion, and both are growing faster than revenue. So overall, Alphabet is obviously a lot more than just search advertising. Let's get to the business highlights. Unless you slept under a rock, you probably already heard of the massive antitrust trial US v. Google. At the heart of this is Google's lucrative deal with Apple, making it the default search engine on iPhones. Google paid Apple 36% of its Safari revenue, resulting in a payment of over $20 billion to Apple annually. This arrangement has put Alphabet in a unique position of influence, but also under intense scrutiny for its potential impact on the market competition. Alphabet is closely monitoring emerging threats and opportunities, with specialized search engines and platforms like TikTok entering the digital landscape. Amazon used to represent only 19% of Google search ad revenue in 2020. 3 years later, it has increased to 28%. So Amazon is definitely catching up. Obviously, the company cannot rest on its laurels to maintain its dominance in the advertising market. Moving now to the media realm, YouTube continues to be a juggernaut. After a brief slowdown, its ad revenue rebounded, accounting for about 94% of Netflix revenue, just to give you a sense of comparison, and it used to be only 90% last year. So it's definitely progressing. This growth underscores YouTube's dominance in the digital video advertising space. YouTube Shorts average over 70 billion daily views, and they are watched by over 2 billion signed-in users monthly. YouTube has gained market share in the living room. The platform now makes up 9.1% of US TV time, and that's up 2 percentage points year over year. Well ahead of Netflix too, which is at 7.2%. By the way, we have a video dedicated to how Netflix makes money on our channel, so if you're interested, just click the link there. In the cloud segment, Google Cloud showed a 22% year-over-year growth. Despite this being a deceleration, it's still impressive and is the fastest growing segment. It was overall ahead of the cloud infrastructure market, which is estimated to grow at 18% year over year in the same quarter. Microsoft Azure has been growing at a faster pace, accelerating to 28% year over year during the same quarter. But keep in mind, Google Cloud includes Google Workspace, so it's not an apple-to-apple comparison. Although cloud's operating margin saw a contraction, it remains the fastest-growing segment and could reaccelerate with AI tailwinds coming up in the coming quarters. Some analysts suspect that Google's vast exposure to smaller client might be influencing the recent slowdown. In addition, some pointed out that Google has been a bit slower at implementing AI features, particularly compared to Microsoft Azure. AI was a key discussion during the latest earnings call. CEO Sundar Pichai shed light on the company's future direction, emphasizing the role of artificial intelligence as the cornerstone of their strategy. Pichai highlighted four key areas where AI is set to make a significant impact. First, there is enhancing knowledge and learning in search tools. Then we have boosting creativity through applications like Bard or Google Lens. Next, we have empowering innovation by offering cloud AI models to developers. And finally, ensuring responsible deployment of AI technology. On the YouTube front, management highlighted recent successes like the launch of NFL Sunday Ticket on YouTube TV. It underscores really YouTube's dominance in the streaming arena. Another interesting development came from Alphabet's Other Bets division, with Waymo gradually expanding its rider base and new partnerships like Wing and Walmart for drone deliveries. CFO Ruth Porat also provided crucial insights, and she highlighted a strategic slowdown in headcount growth, optimization of their real estate footprint, and a focus on cost efficiencies across Alphabet. That also explains why you see these margins improve in the past few quarters. Now, let's talk about the future. As we look ahead, Alphabet is positioning itself at the forefront of the AI craze, starting with Search Generative Experience, or SGE for short. Incorporating AI, it promises a more intuitive and interactive search experience, potentially redefining how we access and use information online. SGE promises to revolutionize how we interact with search engines by integrating generative AI. Google is disrupting itself here by making the experience more similar to ChatGPT. The integration of Bard, Alphabet's conversational AI, into Google's assistant is another milestone to watch. This move could significantly enhance the functionality of the digital assistant, making it more interactive and versatile. Gemini, the upcoming AI system from DeepMind, is set to be a game changer. Poised to compete with OpenAI's ChatGPT, Gemini could redefine the AI landscape with its advanced language and multimodal capabilities, meaning it can process and understand a blend of text, code, audio, images, and video. Gemini comes in three versions. The first one is Gemini Ultra, the largest and the most capable model for complex tasks. Apparently, it outperforms GPT-4 in most tests. For example, it slightly outperforms in reading comprehension and basic math, and significantly outperforms in image recognition and audio tasks. Second, we have Gemini Pro, best for a wide range of tasks, and it's already available. It outperforms GPT 3.5 in most areas. Finally, Gemini Nano, most efficient for on-device tasks, mostly mobile use cases. Now, Google hands-on demo was criticized for being staged. It was shortened for brevity, dubbed after the fact, and not recorded in real time. Well, it makes for a great marketing video. It's not necessarily representative of what the model is capable of today. Now, that being said, the success of Gemini and AI-enhanced search productivity and cloud operations could redefine the tech landscape. But competitors are clearly vying for a share of the market. Alphabet's ongoing investments are about shaping a future where AI is accessible, efficient, and embedded in every aspect of our digital lives. So for more on how AI is impacting our lives, check out our video on the new AI hacks that have emerged and how you can protect yourself. See you right there.